This is Street Stars that I'm here with.
Jack Fresh, the director.
Explain a bit about yourself.
Basically, a music video director, that's how you'll know me, but I'd like to think of myself as a visual artist. So whether that be photography, directing, camera work, or editing.
What part of team are you with?
I'm part of Fresh Entertainment, Fresh Productions, the whole Fresh team.
What's the Fresh team about?
You know what, the Fresh team, I heard G actually explain it. He did a good analogy of it on an interview recently. It's a circle and a collective of talented people, basically. So you've got me, who's like the director, visual person. You've got G, who's the entrepreneur slash rapper. You've got Ty, who's the music producer. And so, but then you'll get someone like Ty that will come and help me on sound effects on my visual stuff. So that all ties in together. You've got the rappers. So you've got Lefty London, Dice Fresh, and Flips.
Okay, can anyone join Fresh?
No.
Like if they have talent,
no.
Can they? Okay.
No. I mean, Fresh is different to some like crews or camps or whatever you want to call them out there, because we actually essentially all sort of grew up in the same area together. We've known each other from a young age. It wasn't like, oh, you do this and you do that, let's get together. It was more like we was all growing up and it was like, rah, should we do this thing? Like, you can do this, you can do that, and let's get it moving. Like, it all started with G, really. G basically decided he wanted to put money into an artist, which was what was my school friend Flips, who's still part of Fresh. And then it just kind of went on from there.
Okay, then you lot have clothing out as well and a production team.
Yeah, so clothing. This is our new t-shirt, Fresh to Death. G's been killing it with the designs lately. I've got one coming out soon. You can see that. Can you see that?
Yeah.
So that's me as a kid. And it says Born Fresh. As you can see, wearing the same glasses from when I was a kid. And then 25 years later, I'm still wearing the Ray-Bans.
What got you into filming and editing? And when did you start?
Well, my whole family is in the film television industry. So I knew that I was going to be doing something along those lines. But what actually got me into it was when we started up Fresh Entertainment and we shot G's first video when we in 2004 now, and then it just kind of went from there. And then I went to university, studied digital media, self-taught myself everything, you know, with regards to editing and filming and stuff. And then I left uni, got my degree, and then got a job at MTV within a week of leaving uni. So I worked for Base as an intern, and then I moved up the next step from an intern, and they made me permanent. And then I had my own show called From the End, which you can go and check out on my YouTube page.
What's the YouTube page?
YouTube page is www.youtube.com/JackFresh.
What music videos have you done previously?
So music videos, I've done all the Fresh music videos, so all of G Fresh's, all of Lefty London, all of the videos that you see with anyone from Fresh in it. I've done videos for Rex32, done videos for Tinchy Strider, Kiny Temper, Young Nate, Kyla, all of Rough Squad. Who else have you done now? I do this all the time. Katie Pearl. Who else? There's more, just go and check them out. I can't remember them all.
Do you do hood videos? And what do you think of the term hood videos?
I don't have a problem with the term hood video at all. I understand what it is and why it's there. But I personally don't think I would do that sort of hood video that I think you're talking about. If you notice that we've released videos, G's videos, and we call them our hood videos, and people go, oh, that's not a hood video. So if you look at our, that is our hood video. So for me, that's a hood video, because we literally shot that video in 2 hours on the back of another video, and it was like no lighting. It was just a quick thing with a camera. So yeah, that, I don't know. I only like to do something where I think the quality of, or the concept is good enough to, you know, put out there.
Okay. If someone wanted to work with you, how would they be able to contact you?
If they wanted to work with me, with regards to, you mean like an artist?
If an artist wanted to get a music video, how would they be able to contact you?
Quite easily. They just either holler at me on Facebook or Twitter, which is all just Jack Fresh. And then I would probably tell them to email one of my producers and give them a breakdown of what they want and the song and stuff, and then we'll go from there.
What's the price range for your hood videos? I mean, well, you don't call them hood videos, you call them music videos.
I don't know, I don't ever actually talk numbers with anyone, and everyone seems to think, oh, Jack thinks he's the most expensive in the game and blah, 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 blah. But, like, if you can see a big difference between two videos quality-wise, then come and talk to me, because that's why I do it, because I don't want to do a video that looks like it costs £10 and then do a video that looks like it costs £100, because this doesn't make sense to me.
How do you create concepts in your head when you're doing videos?
So it would be, first of all, obviously the song. I think with all music videos, it should go music, video. It should never be video, music. So if you notice, a lot of the indie directors will go and do some random kind of like concept which has nothing to do with the song. It's not even cut to the song. It's just they slap the song on top of basically a short film, which is not really, for me, like, what's the point? Go and do a short film in it, don't do a music video. So it starts with just listening to the song and then going from there, and obviously playing on the title of the song. And then also sometimes there'll be elements of the video that might be obvious to the artist, so if the artist has a particular style or calls himself something, or do you know what I mean? So go from there.
Can we see Jack Fresh directing movies?
We can see Jack Fresh directing movies, but not yet, because as yet again, I won't do it unless I feel personally that I'm ready, first and foremost, and secondly, that the project is something that's going to actually be good. I'm not going to do a film just so that you can see my name on a poster. Like, that's not going to happen. So you will one day see me doing films when it's the right. So I'm going to start doing short films soon. You'll see a short film from me this year.
Okay. What do Fresh have in store for the future?
A lot, man. We've got a lot to offer. As I said, like, we're a whole collective of people, so you're going to see a lot. Like, as you know, G Fresh is doing well at the moment, and then we've got these other rappers that are going to be coming through. Ty's producing, and hopefully he'll be producing more people's singles. So he did like Wretch 32 Superhero, and then you'll see me doing a lot more music videos, and also, as I said, moving into short films, adverts, and finally in a film.
Okay, then, is there anything you would like to say to your supporters?
Because I'm grateful for my supporters, and I know it sounds really gay, but there are actually times where I think this is really long and I can't be bothered anymore, and then you'll just get someone that will like message you on Twitter or on Facebook and go like, I really respect what you're doing, and I can't believe that, you know, you was at MTV and you decided to just leave and do your own thing, which I did. I had a job at MTV and I just handed in my notice and went off and did my own thing, which is a bit mad. Like, not one person in my life or family thought that was a good idea, but it's actually turned out quite well. Thanks for the support, man. So, like, recently I had two people ask, they were writing dissertations with me in it, within their uni, like, degree, which was, like, kind of mind-blowing for me, because really, you sure you would actually want to do this? Like, but to them, obviously, I'm doing something that they, you know, would want to one day aspire to, so that's what will help someone like me as well keep going. So I think the problem with the UK is that we're very much like, it's within our culture to be quite introvert, whereas in America, I'm sure, like, if I was just standing here now and someone had seen one of my videos or liked something I'd done, they'd come straight up to me and say, yo, I really like what you're doing, da 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 da. But now we're in the UK, I guarantee, like, those two boys that just walked past a minute ago, they'll go, oh, that's so-and-so, but they won't say nothing to you. They're more likely to shout out abuse at you or something. So, I don't know, it's just strange, but yeah, hopefully we'll change it.